Hello, everybody. Welcome to Science with Tom. I'm Tom. If you're new here, welcome. We mainly do science rap music videos.
Please don't kill my hive. Please don't kill my hive.
But every now and then, I interview a scientist, and I'm so lucky to have Alex McInturf here to help break down the lyrics of our latest collaboration with Minute Earth.
Then this little ape called man wanted to compete.
And the first lyric I want to talk about is the most catchy, the chorus. Food chain, food chain, food chain, food chain, food chain, food chain, woof. Problem with this lyric is that as a science teacher, I like to emphasize food webs. Food chain just sounded catchier. So what's the difference between a food chain and a food web?
So actually, scientists really often use the idea of food chains to simplify the ecosystem we're working in. So we might think of a food chain that's just a line that goes from a mountain lion eating a deer that's eating grass. But obviously, that's an oversimplification. And the reality is that there's also coyotes, bobcats, foxes, other herbivores, other carnivores, and it really looks more like a web than it does like a straight line, like a chain.
You can picture a food web even when I'm saying over and over again, food chain, food chain, food chain, food chain, woof. Another important controversial lyric, everyone's talking about it, the rap genius boards are just exploding here with the line, we can thrive by human side, rise up the food chain till we rule. Now this is sung from the perspective of the Mesopredator, these middle tier carnivores that have been released because apex predators are wiped out. Now, is this a real thing that a Mesopredator could kind of rise up into that apex niche or not?
So it can happen. There are occasions where Mesopredators, when apex predator is removed, will take over that niche more or less. But it's important to point out that no two species are alike. So even if the Mesopredator expands or changes its function, it will never fulfill the same role that an apex predator did. But what we see a lot more commonly is that rather than climb up the food chain, like the song says, often what happens is Mesopredators grow in numbers, expand in range, but retain their trophic position. So they still eat mostly the same things. And that can have important effects.
Sharks getting killed for the fins, too. Boom time for the raisin skates. Ooh. But they eat all the bivalves. Ooh. Humans left with an empty plate.
Because a lot of ecosystem functions that we care about, supporting biodiversity, filtering water, cycling nutrients, all of these things often depend on that food chain being long. And so when trophic system is downgraded, when there's no more apex predators, then sometimes you lose those ecosystem functions.
So the lyric should have been, we can thrive by human side, truncate the food chain until we wreak havoc.
That would probably be the more common situation.
Okay, well, I've got questions about that because it's not entirely clear to me why the Mesopredators cause so many issues where the apex predators don't. So what's special about these middle tier predators that leads to problems when they are released?
Yeah, there's a few characteristics of them that give them the potential to cause these impacts when apex predators are removed. So we know apex predators are large, really big animals. They typically have huge ranges, often solitary or territorial, and so they occur in lower densities than mesopredators generally do. So when they're removed, mesopredators can occur in much higher densities. And because mesopredators occupy that lower trophic position, their diet is more generalist. They can eat a lot more things, and so their impacts are more widespread as well. And the other side of that is that because they have this more generalist diet, they can really take advantage of subsidies that humans are providing, like trash or crops or other things.
And rats. And
rats that come from the human-dominated world. And so it just makes them especially able to thrive when that top-down pressure from the apex predators is removed.
How do we know this stuff? Like how can we tell these stories about, oh, when the apex predators are removed, mesopredators come up? That's a nice story to tell, but how do scientists figure this stuff out?
We do it in a few different ways. The first is to use good old-fashioned experimentation where we control a situation in a laboratory setting and try to manipulate the variables. And that's often done with insects or other smaller animals that are easy to do that with in a laboratory. Going from there, we want to actually go out into the real world, and so people look for simplified ecosystems. Famous example where a starfish is eating mussels and there's only a few players in the ecosystem, so you can really isolate and understand what's happening.
Which basically means remove the starfish and then see what happens.
Exactly. And then the last way is there's just an abundance of evidence where over and over and over we see when apex predators are removed, mesopredators generally expand, grow in numbers, and we see the accompanying effects of that.
Okay, so you get all this data coming in from all these different places, and you just get this like simple, beautiful story, like the Yellowstone story, for example. In our version, we chose to highlight the idea that, okay, when wolves were removed, the coyotes were released, and they started eating all these little mammals, and the species who used to eat those mammals suffered. But that's not the most famous Yellowstone story. So hit me with the big Yellowstone story and any additional nuance that people need to know about.
Yeah, so it's important to explain this because everything in ecology is a little bit more complicated than it seems and even than the stories we tell. And so there's a famous example of a food chain where wolves eat elk, elk eat willows, and by reintroducing the wolves, you're actually allowing the willows to recover and a bunch of ecosystem functions to recover as well. But the story is a little bit more complicated. The wolves did play a role. They do have an important role to play in regulating elk numbers. But what we've learned recently is that drought, climate change, hunting by humans outside of Yellowstone National Park, the return of other predators like grizzlies, these can also play important effects and complicate that ecosystem, turning it from a food chain into a food web.
Food chain, food chain, food chain, food chain, food chain, food chain, woof.
So main point is not that that story is wrong, it's just that as like critical consumers of science, we need to always remember that there's probably a little more complicated variables to the situation.
That's a great takeaway.
Okay. Now, final easy question. Should we just release apex predators everywhere? What is the solution to the havoc being wreaked by mesopredators?
Yeah, I think it's important. We don't want to vilify mesopredators. What's causing these problems is the really rapid pace and intense degree of change that's happening. But the other important piece of that is that there's always winners and losers. There's always trade-offs in ecology. So while the ecosystem might benefit, while tourism might benefit, while our sense of restoring natural systems might benefit, there are people who are going to bear more of the consequences of apex predators. Ranchers, for example, elk hunters, if we're using the Yellowstone example, might actually have their livelihoods suffer because of some of these changes. So it's really important to bear in mind that there's a lot more to ecology than just the science, and we have to think about both the wildlife and the human aspects of it if we want to do a good job.
I think that's a cool question to leave the audience with. Think about the largest wild area that you live near. What is that ecosystem looking like? What would change if apex predators were doing better in that particular area? Who would the winners and losers be? And how would the human beings have to come together to like make that work? Thank you for coming. Thank you for joining me, Alex.
My pleasure, Tom.
And thank you for sticking around for Science Rap Academy. We got 7 more videos coming out this season. See you then.
Food chain, food chain, food chain, food chain, food chain, food chain, woof. Apex out, we the new thing.
Youth.
And we don't need a huge range.
Oof.
As you get killed by the humans,
oof.
Mesopredator's gonna move in.
Roof.